It's not that math is important to me. It's just math is one of those things where, you know, you have to be good with numbers. There's so many fields that require you to use numbers, from business to math to science to social sciences. And if you're good with numbers, all of that stuff is easy. And when you're bad with numbers, especially big numbers, all of those fields are very difficult. So it's not really math. I just want kids to be comfortable with numbers, to actually understand how to work with numbers to make them easy and to become good problem solvers, not just in math, but really in anything. Most kids don't like math. And the reason is most kids are bad at math. And the reason most kids are bad at math is most adults are bad at math. So we're not teaching kids how to become good at math. It turns out there's two ways to do math. There's an easy way and there's a hard way. Most people do math the hard way. They do a lot of counting. They do a lot of memorizing. They do a lot of skip counting. They do a lot of things that are actually making math harder. Now, kids that are good in math all use the same strategy. They're very good at taking big numbers and breaking them into smaller numbers. When they have to solve a big problem, they break it into smaller problems. So it turns out there's one strategy that I try to tie everything to. If something is too big, you make it manageable by breaking it into smaller pieces. Now, the question is, what are the right pieces? Most kids take big numbers and break them into ones. So they're breaking them into the wrong pieces. Now, if a kid learns to break the numbers down in groups bigger than one, they learn to stop counting, all of a sudden they have a chance to be good in math. So that's really what my program and my strategies are all about, teaching kids how to be great with numbers. I combine math with picture books for a couple reasons. One, it's to communicate the math concepts more clearly. I think a lot of people started out writing math picture books as a way to make math more palatable to teachers, especially that don't like math, and then kids that don't like math. So if a person is more comfortable with reading, if you give them a book that's got words and pictures, but it's really math, that's better for them. The problem with that is a lot of the original books in math were really the old math concepts based on memorization and not a lot of understanding, and then we put words and pictures around them. So you have a better version of these kind of strategies that kind of didn't work. And so what I tried to do is say, no, the key is to come up with better math concepts first, and then use pictures and words to communicate better concepts in a more effective way. So what I've really tried to do with my books is come up with better strategies and then also communicate them to kids in a better way through words and pictures. So that's really why I write math picture books. Math Potatoes is one of those where I'm trying to think of how to write a poem about potatoes. So the math problem was to figure out how many potatoes. So I had these potatoes in groupings. And I'm thinking to myself, boy, there's so many ways to eat a potato. You got hash browns, you got baked potatoes, you got mashed potatoes. So I'm writing this, thinking of all these ideas, and I came up with this idea that I thought was good. Potatoes au gratin, the kind that are best forgotten. So I thought that was funny. Turns out it's not. But it did give me an idea for how to structure the poem, so the poem ended up something like this. Boiled and baked and often mashed, peeled and fried and sometimes hashed. No wonder they hide underground. Life is painful when they're found. Can you add up these poor souls for whom the bell already tolls? In groups of 10, you'll hear their cries. Please don't turn us into fries. So the clue in that poem was don't think in doubles, which is what everybody does. If you see a 4 next to a 4, most people will think 8. But if you see a 4, should you put it with the 4? No, what goes better with a 4? How about a 6? So the whole key is to think in groups of 10, not to think in doubles. So again, I use all my poems to teach important math strategies. I try to make them funny by using poems and using wordplay and bad puns. And that kind of just gives me a kick out of it. It makes me enjoy writing. So I have a new poem that I just wrote on bats and echolocation. That's in the new book, Math Fables 2, and the name of that poem is The Sound and the Furry.
For more author interviews, recommended reading lists, and information about teaching kids to read, please visit us online at www.readingrockets.org.